Operational report. Submarines detected. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five heavy bombers written off. I don't care if this is the United States. Nope, we don't get five bombers replacements per day. We can't. This is going to be unsustainable pretty damn quickly. Repairs complete. Chittagong. Oh, we got some supplies. Oh, okay. Here's a couple of terminated and disbanded because they couldn't get any. But the others are loading supplies. So maybe we'll have to create a few more. Wait. What is this one? Task Force 20. Why are we delivering to Akyab? Well, okay. We'll have to change that. Contact report. Contact report. Another pilot is killed. Recon over Hiroshima. Over Iwo Jima, Langkawi, and Tanjung Pinang, as well as Chichijima. Contact report. No attacks, though. Contact report. Orshan is captured. Wen Chao expands and Hanoi expands. Refit begins. Upgrades. Repairs complete. Refit begins. Repairs complete. Upgrades. Replacements. There's the New Zealand Brigade. Now she's building over on Guam. Reinforcement arrived. Cristobal and Portland. Just to show what the aircraft losses were this turn. We'll see from the Allied side. We lost 3, 6 heavy bombers for all causes. Well, only one due to flak, but the rest even on ops losses. Operational losses can mean being damaged and then crashing on the way home, so I could have lost the pilot as well. Regardless, it's still 6 bombers out of my fleet, and that's exceeds my replacement rate. We're getting good hits, but at such a high cost. First order of business is to take care of Task Force 20. Obviously, Task Force 20 was set for Akyab. Now we're going to take that, change it, set it for Rangoon. I don't know how it got to Akyab. Okay, we'll put it back on computer control. Continuous supply. Direct and coastal route. Hopefully that'll work. Several ships have dropped out of the stream, and I'm okay with. I'm just going to leave them off right now. They can repair. There's an AKE and a submarine tender. I'll let them repair for now. These big ships are more valuable than the little ones, so I don't mind if they don't get used. Let the little coastal steamers earn their keep. That's what they're best used. And these guys are, we have more than we need. We just can't get enough supplies down here, damn it. Okay, let's take a look at Hong Kong. Hong Kong, we have submarines in, but they're all under refit. Shanghai. Whoa! Look at Tambor and Grenadier got in. Fantastic. Well done, Tambor. You got, just getting her home was a feat of seamanship. Let's see, how many of these are requiring upgrade. Whoa, lots of them. Okay, Tambor, Sculpin, and Sea Dragon. Luckily, all three of these guys are going into repair anyway. Sculpin is going deep shipyard for all that damage. Grenadier, Tambor. Wow, 10 days. That's it, 10 days to fix all that. The Sea Dragon is also going to go into pierside, and Gunnel, I'll drop them in the shipyard. That's some pretty serious damage on these guys. That leaves us just Grayling. Grayling, guess where you're going? Yep, Shikoku Station. When in doubt, put it on Shikoku. That's where the action is. Oh, the other thing to remember, I tried to remind myself, is to we're gonna pull back the escorts for the. Yeah, we killed another pilot for nothing. Let's pull back the range to 2. All P-40 Echoes, they just can't cover Fuchao, and it's killing them trying to get out there. So we're just going to have to get a base force out there to do it for us. And we are now, where's that base force? Has just, oh, here it is, still moving towards New Chow. The Japanese force at Nagasaki has been hit. We didn't get very much though. We hit the port, got a few repair yard damage, 5 points of damage on the repair shipyard. So that, well, if the AI tries to repair it, that'll still eat up 5,000 points. Not bad, not bad. But we didn't get any indication that the carriers have been sunk. I would like to try it again, so we're going to keep the missions, keep going after Nagasaki until we can wipe out the shipyard. Better to kill the escorts and everything. There's destroyers down here and minesweepers, so better to kill them while they're docked than on the open seas. We'll conduct the reconnaissance from Fusan. Yep, there's fatigue of 3 and 2, so we're going to switch out the set all recon, and then we'll take the two least with zero fatigue. I'm going to keep flying it over Hiroshima. That way, once we destroy Nagasaki, the ships here, we should be able to switch to Hiroshima without any delay. Where the sweeps gone through. Oops, not sorry, not the Soviets. The fighter sweeps. Oh, they didn't go. They still have a fatigue level 1. So I think I'm going to order them again. Nagasaki. And oh, both 2 for Nagasaki. The bombers from, whoa. Yeah, no. Let's all level bomb. Oops, pardon me. These are at night, so we have to set, you have to use a night setting. We're going to arrest all the 17 B-17s. They've done well. They've taken some pretty heavy losses. Let's divide this group. That way we can add extra bombers. Otherwise, we're restricted to the ones, a maximum of 4 for the entire group. Okay, so these bombers will recover. We have 6 bombers in reserve. We're only allowed 4, so this group will divide so that the bombers don't get taken back into the pool. Same here. There's 5 here, so that's the 6 here. 6 extra bombers. We'll divide them so we're not penalized, hopefully. And this one. All recovering. While they're recovering, what do I do with the Mitchell bombers here? Okay, well, I'm gonna risk it. The Mitchells, okay, we'll run the risk. The Mitchells are going to fly a mission. We'll keep that back. Let's hit the port. Let's see if we hit it during the day. That's much more risky, especially at low level, at 5,000. Well, we won't know if we don't try. Bombers at Keijo. The Delta ones have done their duty. Look at that. Took some pretty heavy losses, pilots-wise, too. So we'll take them off. We'll find there should be 3 or 4. Yep, here's a Liberator squadron, 0 fatigue. Here's another Liberator squadron, 0 fatigue. So 2. And well, I guess we'll have to find a couple of those with fatigue of 1. We need four squadrons. I think this probably. Oops. One, two, three. Oh, this one has a fatigue level 2. I don't think we'll send it. So we have four squadrons of fatigue level 1 that we're going to use. This one will remain divided. So that we can add a few bombers. We're still chasing down the road to Mishan. We wiped out this border fortress. Now we're moving northeasterly to try and destroy this. I think it's a border fortress. Last one. Maybe now we'll be able to move this guy in. If they move in at the same time with another fortress. Okay, one up here. This guy is going to block. We'll send two more over here just in case. Orshan, after wiping them out, I'm putting them on the rail. Let's see if we can go down here and lend a hand at Mishan. We'll take a train down, and if we have time, we'll march down the road. Maybe we can help them clean out the last ones at Kotao. Marching the armored units back up to Hanoi while the infantry deploy from the train. If we're gonna march on this guy, if we're gonna take Haiphong, I'm just gonna march right down here. If we have to give him a shock attack, well, we'll bring the whole damn army down his throat. So hopefully one turn to kill it. No other reinforcements arriving from the rear. Bangkok is quiet. Yeah, nobody moving through. Just building up. Same in Malaya. Just holding on, letting the enemy attack us. S-38. Oh, she's ready. Okay, we'll send her back out on patrol. No changes to the aircraft or missions here. The convoy arrives safely at Colombo. Nothing happening on Bombay. Just convoy in and out at Abadan. South Africa. Our first convoy has 50,000. Sure. I think it's enough to sail. Head for Bombay. We'll form another transport. Use up the rest of the... Hold on. Let's see. Are we supposed to? Okay. Suppress the ships that are going to upgrade. We'll grab the big ones. Try to get all the same speed first. 12s. Another 60,000 follows that first convoy once it gets done. No other reinforcements. Let's check submarines. Puffer! Okay, these guys are almost back. Well, these guys are not. Saori got hit mid-ocean. Long way home. Okay. K-18 is also limping back. No other submarines damaged. Let's check for endurance. Greyback. Salmon and Growler are already returning. Torpedo check. About 10 torpedo engagements from various submarines. All of them still have weapons in their magazines, so they'll continue their patrol. Still the unengaged submarine near Townsville. Hopefully one of these guys will react towards it. The Dutch cruisers are just passing Maryborough on their way to Brisbane. Here's the first transport group heading in. The second transport group is arriving, and here are the ones that escorted the Medusa down to Sydney. Okay, they're changing course, going to merge with this new tanker force. convoys arrive on Wootjimaloalap, Ilinglaplap, and just about almost at Roy Namur. We're going to drop a few hundred, 140,000 onto this area. That'll put them each up, maybe over 100,000. But hopefully this will last a lot longer since they're not actually throwing it away on bombing away at Majuro. Panama, we have a minesweeper arrived. The force, I wonder if there's enough route. Let's see. Does force have enough fuel to get to Pearl Harbor? No. 100 has a range of 100, and I think the distance is 122. I'm going to send them over to, okay, we'll move to Balboa, and then we'll hook up with one of the transports and tag along so that they can refuel us as we go. These guys aren't going to be leaving anytime soon. Pearl Harbor, the seaplane tender Langley has finally returned, unloaded, and now she's ready for her upgrade. She's over a year late. She's already missed one upgrade, and here's our second upgrade. So she'll be gone for 3 weeks. I especially like the Langley because she can operate aircraft, Kingfishers, which are almost like a little cruiser, where she can sweep ahead of a task force or sweep an area, anti-submarine for search for an area. The carrier group, or the escort carrier group, has arrived at San Francisco. We're going to put her in for some minor repairs, send the other ones back up to Victoria. We have a transport group down. We formed up another one. These are all the transports that are available right now. We're going to load troops. We're going to take the base force up. This was a recent reinforcement. We're going to no fuel to load. And accept. One other reinforcement at Portland. We'll form transport. Bring them down to San Francisco. No other reinforcements. Let's check Vancouver. Ships returning. These guys are emptying so that they won't upgrade, I don't think, unless they are empty. So we're emptying the fuel out of them. These guys are loaded. Okay, we'll take the loaded ones and send them off down to Pearl. More convoys have arrived at Guam. The replenishment group returning from Hajima. Is that Hajima? Yeah, Hajima. They're loading right now, getting ready for the next push. These guys are unloading. Where are the transport groups? Yeah, the AEs. They're loading, getting ready for the next bombardment mission. Now notice how much these guys carry. 76,000 supply points. And that's just part of it. So we've probably got carrying capacity for well over 100,000 right now, of which much of it is up at Hajima. The carrier group has moved off. Here's the assault force. I've ordered the assault force not to unload. I don't want, if it gets to Iwo Jima ahead of time, I want everyone to just sit there so they unload at the same time. If it arrives at the end of the phase, they might only a few ships might unload, and the rest would not. This would trigger a shock attack, probably destroy the few ships that did unload. So I want them, when I unload, I want everyone to unload with full force. The carriers, with their superior speed, I think they should be arriving here just ahead of them. We've bombed and destroyed a number of transports over here, probably trying to reinforce. I think it's trying to reinforce. Anyway, these guys, here's the second wave. I think they'll get in here. They'll probably arrive somewhere around here next turn. I don't think the enemy has any active aircraft around here, so I don't have to worry too much about it. This is an AP moving east, so it's heading this direction. Again, evacuation or reinforcement? I'm hoping it's reinforcement so we can kill some more. Hahajima is still preparing bombardment groups coming out. The scamp fires a torpedo and finally hits a submarine. She's a goner. Bombardment Chichijima. No hits. Bombardment Iwo Jima. Oh, good. See, we're still hitting the casualties, still suppressing them, still disabling. Look at them, how spread out they are, the amphibious and the covering carriers. Pargo evades an anti-submarine warfare attack. Grayling fires six torpedoes. Look, this destroyer really is leading a charmed life. But Grayling misses, or no, more likely they're duds, and Grayling is hit twice in return. Oh, the escorting a the convoy inbound, the escorts run over the I-27, hit it 3 times, but it also manages to fire 2 torpedoes at a corvette. Air attack on Fuchao. The enemy gets to practice too. Oh, we finally get an air attack off the Vengeance. Dive bomb on a 2 subchasers. Both are hit, one is sunk outright. Finally, something triggered. Air attack Sasebo. The lightnings are sweeping, destroying 4 nates. It also, there's a B-25 Mitchell search plane has dropped, supposedly hitting a Japanese sub chaser. Second air attack. The sub chaser that survived is bombed and killed. The other bo dive bombers hit the troops at Tanjung Pinang, disabling 4 more support squads. Another squad is disabled. Miss. The Mitchells disable 4 more squads. 5. Long range air attack on Hahajima. 6 Bettys. One is destroyed. The Australian 7th Corps is bombed at Hanoi. 1 Betty destroyed. No damage to the ground troops. Our ships have arrived over top of Iwo Jima, and there are the carriers. Man, I couldn't have planned it better myself. Whoo, what luck! What are these up here? Transport. Troop transport and a gunboat. Well, if the carriers aren't needed here, I think we'll move northward, trying to pick off these 2 task forces.